So this lesson is going to be looking at the principle of inclusion or exclusion. Okay? And what we're interested in this is we're interested in counting the elements in one or two sets when the sets have some elements in common that are common to both sets. So they appear in the intersection of the two sets. Okay? And what we're actually going to be doing is become a little bit more clear just as we go through an example here. So here's our first example. Some background here. The principle of inclusion-exclusion is important when we are interested in the union of two sets, and there are elements in the intersection of the sets. So it has to do, again, with these Venn diagrams that we've been working on. So for example, 30 people are surveyed about TV shows, 15 people liked Big Bang Theory, 20 people liked Modern Family, and 10 people liked both of them. How many people liked Big Bang Theory or Modern Family? Okay, so here, this word both should tip us off that we're dealing with the intersection of these two sets. They liked Big Bang Theory and Modern Family. Okay, whereas this word down here, or, tells us that they are asking us about the union of two sets. So they're giving us some information about the intersection. They're asking us to find some information about the union. A good place to start, though, is to draw a Venn diagram. So we'll have... Hey, that was fun, wasn't it? Let's try this again. So we've got our rectangle here. The rectangle, of course, represents our universal set S, which is all of the things that we're interested in this question. So in this case, that's the 30 people that we surveyed, asked questions of in our survey. So let's create a couple of subsets here. We'll call one of them B. That's for the people who like Big Bang Theory. Set of people who like, and I'll just say Big Bang Theory. Okay. So we'll have this set here. This will be B. And we'll have M be a set of people who like Modern Family. And I'll draw these two things intersecting like this in our Venn diagram here. So they give us some numbers in the questions about who likes what here. So let's fill in these numbers here. We know that 15 people liked Big Bang Theory. So we know that inside this circle B here, we should have a total of 15 people. Okay? We know that 20 people liked Modern Family. So inside this circle for M here, we should have a total of 20 people. We don't know where they should go, whether they should go in sort of this region here or this region over here or anything like that. Okay? They tell us that 10 people liked both of them. So that's the intersection. So we can put those 10 people right here in our intersection. Okay? Those are the ones who like both. Now, and then we can go back and look at the pieces of information we're given before. If 15 people in total like the Big Bang Theory, we need to have 5 more people out here so that there's a total of 15 inside that set B. If 20 people in total like Modern Family, we need to have another 10 people over here so that there's a total of 20 inside that Modern Family thing. So now how many people like Big Bang Theory or Modern Family? Well, what they're asking us to find with this question is the number of people that are in the union of our sets B and M. B union M. So how many people in total are there? Well, we can see from here that there are 25 people inside those two things. And I guess the other five people in our survey must be out here. They didn't like anybody, either of the two shows. So often you can work this out using a Venn diagram. You can also do this algebraically using the principle of inclusion or exclusion. And what the principle of inclusion or exclusion says is that the number of elements in the union of two sets is equal to the number in A plus the number in B minus the number that are in the intersection of those two sets. So for our question, the number of people in the union of these two sets, B and M, is going to equal the number of people in set B plus the number of people in set M minus the number of people in the intersection of the two of them. Now, which pieces of information are we given in the question, and what are we trying to find in the question? So let's just flip back here and take a look at the question here. Okay. 15 people liked Big Bang Theory, 20 people liked Modern Family, and 10 people liked both. Okay. So we know that what we are given here is we are given the number of people who liked Big Bang Theory. Let's just write this out. The number of people who liked Big Bang Theory was 15. The number of people who liked Modern Family was 20. And the number of people who liked both, or the number in the intersection, was our 10. What are we being asked to find? Well, we're being asked to find the union over here. So we can just plug these numbers into this formula. It's going to be 15 plus 20 minus 10, okay, which gets us our 25, just like before. Okay? Now, sometimes we'll be given information about the number in one set, number in the other set, and we'll be asked to solve for the intersection rather than being asked to solve for the union. But the principle is the same. Okay? Now, this is what the principle of inclusion-exclusion is for two sets. It's on your formula sheet. There is also a principle of inclusion-exclusion for three sets. And there's one for four sets, and five sets, and six sets, and so on, and so on, and so on. So we'll do one here for the principle with three sets. If we were interested, what this is telling us is the number of things in the union of A, B, and C, so the union of our three sets, is equal to the number in A, B, and C individually, minus the number in the intersection between each of them, so the intersection of A and B, minus the number in the intersection of A and C, minus the number in the intersection of B and C, and then plus the number in the intersection of all three of them. Okay? So this is the pattern that principles of inclusion and exclusion kind of follow. First, you add in the individual sets, you subtract intersection of two of them, add intersections, and then if we were to keep going, the next line would be subtracting intersections, and the next line after that would be adding more intersections. So an example here. How many integers from 1 to 100 are divisible by 2, 3, or 5? Okay. So let's start. What we're being asked to solve here is the number in the union of these three sets. Okay? The number that are divisible by 2, or by 3, or by 5. So first we need to figure out the number in each set individually. So we'll let this be the number of things that are divisible by 2, number of integers divisible by 2. How many are there? Well, there's going to be 50, because there's 50 even numbers between 1 and 100. How many things are going to be divisible by 3? There's going to be 33 of them. And basically what you can do is you can take 100, divide it by 3, Okay, you get 33 and a third equals 33.33. Well, not 3.33. 33.3, and then you just round it down. We could have done the same thing up here. We take 100, divide by 2, we get our 50 things. Number of things divisible by 5? Well, let's see. 100 divided by 5 gives us 20. So that's sort of the first line taken care of here. Now we want to subtract off the intersections. So we need to figure out how many things are divisible by 2 and by 3. Well, if a number is divisible by both 2 and 3, it's got to be divisible by the product of 2 and 3, or divisible by 6. So if we take 100, divide it by 6, we end up with 16.66, something like that. So there's going to be 16 of them. For the number that are divisible by 3 and 5, we are looking for things that are divisible by 15. So we do 100 divided by 15, and then we round down. We end up with 6 things there. Next up, we want the number of things that are divisible by 2 and 5. Well, if they're divisible by both 2 and 5, then they must be divisible by 10. So in this case, we're going to have 10 things here. And finally, we need the number of things that are divisible by 2 and 3 and 5. If they're divisible by 2 and 3 and 5, they have to be divisible by 30. So let's say 100 minus 30 gives us 3.3, so we round it down, and we're going to have 3 things. So let's put this into our formula. The number divisible by 2 or 3 or 5 is going to be, first, the number divisible by 2, 3, and 5 separately. So our 50 plus our 33 plus our 20 minus our first set of intersections here, so 16, 6, and 10. So minus 16, minus 6, minus 10. And then we add in the intersection of all three of them, plus 3. Punch this into our calculator, and we end up with 74. So there are 74 numbers between 1 and 100, sorry, 74 integers between 1 and 100 that are either divisible by 2, by 3, or by 5.